of this auspicious occasion. Let me begin by thanking the West Java Province government officials who give their level best to arrange and coordinate in answering this important business meeting, or let's say West Java Week talk show, run well. I would like to give a brief on potentials of Indonesia. Indonesian small and medium enterprises firms with less than 100 workers have historically been the real player in domestic economic activities, with business operation is up to 99.99% of the total population and employed more than 116 million people. And this forum evidently shows the growing significance development of the small and medium enterprises, especially in the province of West Java. Thus, I sincerely hope you also share with me the view that Indonesia's SMEs would become source of new economic growth with great potentials and direct the national economy in becoming more inclusive. Ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia is also known as a champion of women empowerment. More than 42% of Indonesia's population are women. For this particular reason, investing in gender equality is the right and wise thing to do, because it brings out benefits to business environment and faster economic growth. Efforts to empower women in the economy, especially the creative industries, is the answer. Women have succeeded in dominating 53.86% of the labor absorption in the creative industry sector. Distinguished guests, another strong point of doing business with Indonesia is the Sharia economy development. It is impossible to turn a blind eye on the peaking interest of Sharia economy in Indonesia. As highlighted in the Indonesia Halal Economy and Strategic Roadmap, there are clear opportunities for domestic consumption and growth, exports and imports substitution. In line with the Indonesian government's development plan, Islamic economic and financial development will include, first one is the development of halal product industry. The second, development of the Islamic financial industry. The third, development of Islamic social funds. And the last one, the fourth, the development and expansion of Sharia business activities. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to again mention that Indonesia is a big country with vast opportunities. Known for its abundant natural resources and equipped with young labor force, Statistics Indonesia notes that Indonesia gross domestic product grows on the average of 5.17% year on year before the pandemic. Although there are challenges, Indonesia's economy remains resilient, supported by a high domestic demand from increased social spending and a strong labor market. Indonesia's growth outlook remains substantial to becoming one of the emerging market economies of the world. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, strategic policies are directed to attract capital flows, such as stimulus package of friendly investment environment, are apt to make geoeconomic and geo-advantages for inviting investors to Indonesia. I wish this presentation, the West Java talk show, will cater to your interest. Through innovating partnerships among companies and people, in turn, we could provide opportunities and support as the catalyst supporting public and private partnerships that finally turning them into creative economy engines and an infinite amount of potential for future success. Before I conclude, I want to reiterate the Consulate General of the Republic of Indonesia's in Dubai commitment to provide support and facilitation for growing mutually beneficial cooperation. Please stay safe and remain strong. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Mr. Budi Prihantono. Ladies and gentlemen, before we move on to the next session, I would like to introduce to you a little bit about Ibu Atalia Praratia Ridwan Kamil to the audience here. Ibu Atalia is known as the First Lady of West Java. She is also the head of Dekranasta. She is currently a doctoral candidate in communications. She leads many organizations and movements, from scout organizations to early education. But one of her passions is West Java Craft Council. which participates in this week's World Expo. Her motto is, life is a choice. In life, you have to give benefits to the others. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for Ibu Atalia Praratia Ridwan Kamil.
Thank you very much. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, everyone. Sampurasun. Baik. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa syukurillah, asyhadu alla ilaha illallah, wa asyhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Your Excellencies, thank you for coming. Bapak Budi Prihantoro, Minister Counselor of KJRI, and also Ibu Novita Nugraheni, Spouse of General Counselor of KJRI, Diaspora Indonesia, the head and members of Dekranasta from 27 cities and regencies in West Java who are coming today online. All distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Welcome to West Java Talk Show in World Expo Dubai. Thank you for joining us in this beautiful event to share about how beautiful and potential West Java Indonesia is. I hope everyone is in a good, healthy, and also happy condition. My name is Atalia. I'm the head of West Java Craft Council, and I'm here with Pak Dedi as head of Tourism and Culture Department, and also Pak Arifin as head of Industry and Trade Department, and also the cultural delegation of West Java. Today, we would like to share to you about West Java potential resources in tourism, creative economy, and also halal industry. But before that, let me begin by introducing Indonesia. Silakan, slide-nya. Indonesia. Yeah. Indonesia is an archipelago in Southeast Asia with more than 16,000 islands stretching from Aceh to Papua, bordering with Singapore, Brunei, Malaysia, Papua New Guinea, and also Australia. With 34 provinces and Jakarta as the capital city, Indonesia is home to 272 million population. Indonesia is also next surrounded by seas, islands, volcanoes, jungles, and numerous flora and fauna with many tribes. We have more than 718 languages and 1,340 tribes. And this is West Java. West Java is one of the most important provinces in Indonesia. West Java population is the biggest in Indonesia, which is nearly 50 million people, almost the same the size of South Korea population, twice the size of Australia, and 10 times the size of New Zealand's population. We are also the neighboring province to Jakarta, the capital city of Indonesia. With 27 regions, West Java plays a major strategic role in the national economy, accounting for 16.2% non-oil and gas exports and 28.5% of manufacturing production. 60% of all industries in Indonesia are located in West Java. So if you want to invest in manufacturing and industry, we are the right place to do the business. Our economic growth now is 6.13%. And we are the number one investment in destination in Indonesia. Why? Because of infrastructure readiness, quality investment process, and also most productive human capital. West Java have 4.6 million productive entrepreneurs so far. Ladies and gentlemen, our people now are hungry for more infrastructure. We need to build more airports, seaports, toll roads, railways, and build more new towns. So that is the reason why investment in West Java will be a great opportunity. Today, West Java grows and becomes a digital province of Indonesia. We have 5,957 villages that we need to integrate in one command through our command center. We are also changing our vocational curriculum to be ready for robotics, stocks, artificial intelligence, and also Internet of Things. This year, West Java is running to digitalize many rural ecosystems. We built application for farmer, for fishermen, and any rural-related businesses, including e-commerce for small and medium enterprises. Also, during this pandemic era, we built application for COVID control and information called Picobar. Now we are talking about creative economy. As the majority of our population are young generation, creative economy is becoming West Java's strongest growth. For example, in 2015, the capital of West Java, Bandung, was declared as UNESCO Creative City Network in design sector. We have many strong subsector creative economy from culinary, fashion, craft, music, and many more. Most of them are small and medium enterprises. That's why to improve our business environment, Dekranasda with all the stakeholders are doing EEP, empowering people, educating people, and also promoting their products. Our goal is to support national economic independence with local creative economy. We make sure that craftsmen in every region are well-trained on their own potentials so that they can compete in the globalization era. This picture shows an example to sell craft training where participants are housewife and also local people. And now we are happy to say that we've got a new strength. There are 2,574 Islamic boarding school that have already trained with OPPO program, one pesantren, one product, and we are ready to go global. Ladies and gentlemen, UNESCO has identified some intangible raw materials for craft product, from clay to metal, and all of this product can be found in West Java. Let me show you some product that our local people have created and marketed. Silakan. This is clay. Yeah, this is clay. Most of them are produced in Cirebon and Pleret, Purwakarta. Next, stone from Bogor, Tasik, and also Garut. This is natural fiber from Subang and Tasik. Wood from Sukabumi and Bandung. Metal from usually used for decorative lights, accessories, and so on from Pongkor, Bogor, and Cianjur. And this is textile product, something that we really proud of. This product include batik, tenun, sarung, knit, and also embroidery. In 2009, Indonesian batik has been acknowledged by UNESCO as intangible cultural heritage. These products have their own techniques, symbolism, and culture surrounding their creations. Each pattern of batik has their own uniqueness, and all of the city and region in West Java already have batik patterns with their own unique local wisdom. As you can see in what I'm wearing right now, this is Sutra Bulu from Tasikmalaya, and this is from Garut, batik from Garut. Okay, next, how about halal product? 90% of West Java people are Muslim. So every product related to halal will be a big opportunity. Either selling product to 45 million Muslim in West Java or producing halal product in West Java to be sold to the world market. In Rebana region, the northern part of West Java, we are designing one new industrial town dedicated for halal industries and factories. For more detail about halal industry will be explained by Pak Arifin later. And these are the example of West Java potential product. We have Muslim product consists of halal cosmetic, Persian Muslim wear, and also various creative products such as ceramic mug, wooden spoon, fork, knife, bamboo, musical instrument, wooden clock, and so on. Next. Okay. Last but not least, our province is just like Bali. If you ever been there, the landscape is so beautiful. We have many culture, expressions such as buildings, musical instruments, traditional dances, and languages, many products and abandoned tourist destinations. In the next 5 years, we will add 27 new tourist destinations that will expose the beauty and the uniqueness of our local wisdom. For further explanation about tourism will be presented by Pak Dedi. Okay. Now let me show you West Java in a glance. Silakan videonya. That's all for now. Hope you will have an opportunity to see the beauty of West Java soon, or at least enjoy our products in this expo. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you. A very inspiring speech indeed, Bu Atalia. Ladies and gentlemen, now I would like to invite Ibu Novita Nugraheni Negara to join us on stage to receive a special souvenir from Ibu Atalia. To Ibu Novita Nugraheni Negara, you may join us on the stage now. Thank you very much. We may take a pictures together. Thank you. To Ibu Atalia and Ibu Novita, you may take your seat now. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm afraid that is the end of our session today with Ibu Atalia. Thank you for joining us with us today. Ibu Atalia, to Ibu Atalia and Mr. Budi, you may leave the stage. Thank you very much. And now, let's move on to today's discussion. This afternoon, we will have 3 presentations, and I would like to invite them all to the stage. First, I would like to ask the head of West Java Tourism and Cultural Agency, Mr. Dedi Taufik, to come to the stage. Mr. Arifin Sujayana, the head of Industry and Trade Agency, please join Mr. Dedi Taufik on the stage. And last but not least, Ustadz Perry from Darut Tauhid Boarding School as the representative of One Pesantren, One Product program. Please join Mr. Dedi Taufik and Mr. Arifin Sujayana on the stage. Before moving on to our first presenter, I would like to inform the audience that the presentation will be given continuously. With Q&A at the end of the last presentation. Bapak Ibu yang terhormat, presentasi akan diberikan oleh semua pembicara terlebih dahulu, dan waktu untuk berdiskusi akan diberikan setelah semua pembicara menyampaikan materinya. Bapak Ibu yang mengikuti talk show ini dari Indonesia, bisa ikut berdiskusi setelah semua presentasi selesai. As for our first presenter, I would like to welcome Mr. Dedi Taufik, the head of West Java Tourism and Cultural Agency. Mr. Dedi Taufik will talk about tourism in West Java, culture and the beauty of West Java, and overall potential of West Java tourism. Mr. Dedi Taufik, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dedi Taufik, and I'm speaking as the head of West Java Province Culture and Tourism Department. I would like to thank you all for being here and gathered at this fruitful event. I do hope that God will shower you with a plenty of blessing. Today, I would like to highlight the beauty of West Java that has been supported our province economic stability as well is becoming the most favorite and desirable destination for domestic and international tourists. Next, this West Java profile. West Java is located in the western part of the Java Island, and Bandung is its capital. As a part of the Pacific Ring of Fire, we have more mountain and volcano than any of the other province in Indonesia. This largest volcanic area is traditionally known as Parahyangan, also known as Priangan and Preanger, which means the abode of Hyang Gaj. Next slide. With 27 city and regency along the area, West Java has been invited more than 60 million international and domestic tourists altogether. Supported with two accessible international airports, one Bandara Kertajati and Hussein Sastranegara in Bandung. 12 train stations and 13 ports, including more than 700 travel agency and tour agency stand as our essential support for the tourists. West Java also support with necessary facility like hotel, homestay, various culinary destination including cafe, dinners, and restaurant. West Java has been the host of more than 100, even with a lot of category, such as culinary, sport, music, fashion, and other exhibition that enlighten entertainment during the stay. Next slide, yeah. This top destination in West Java. This is our top destination that you can enjoy whenever you visit our province. This white sand beach located in Pangandaran, the southeast part of West Java, invite you to spend your holiday there. And the white crater known as Kawah Putih, the magnificent and cascade waterfall that you can find in West Java that could make you want to revisit again. This is the legend of historical and namely based our local wisdom. This Tangkuban Perahu is the best and perfect place to see one of the activity volcanic mountain in West Java. The other safari park in Bogor that provide an exquisite experience riding your car while talking close look the wild animal to and Jatiluhur ya, Jatiluhur Reservoir, 3 Ciater Tourism Area, For and also Trend Studio Bandung that provide endless indoor entertainment and that are family friendly and also provide with budget and luxury stay around the area. Let's blend ourselves in this nature destination. Here we are serve you beautiful Gede Pangrango. Gede Pangrango Mountain serving in international surf destination and at Batu Karas, Pangandaran. Incredible Citambur waterfall and see a conservation turtle at Pangumbahan Beach. Next slide. This here another activity you can do when visit West Java, see the city view of Bandung through hot air balloon in Subang Regency, horsing race at Kuningan Regency and water climbing at Cikondang Waterfall. Next, this our culture, the culture in West Java also be the main attraction for the tourists to explore. There is a glimpse of Javanese and pink of Batawi, yeah, Batawi and Sundanese authentic culture. Angklung is the local music developed by Sundanese culture and form of a bamboo musical instrument that turn into beautiful rhythm. This in Sukabumi, there is Cipta Gelar, yeah, Cipta Gelar village that famous for the phenomenal and secret festival named Serentown. In Cirebon, we can find the mass dance that will entertain the audience by the wide variety of mass color, music, and unique dancing that will bring the value of leadership, love, and wisdom to everyone watching. And there is a traditional food by meat of buffalo served white rice, and this traditional food and West Java also being center of creative art, yeah, craft and economy. This Pala Nusantara, yeah, Pala Nusantara as a handmade creative watch. The gate game developed that has become the leader of Indonesia biggest game company. And Rattan Chair, one of our unique and local furniture product. Next. West Java operate tourism investment potential that consists of 20 green book and 2 brown book that are completed and ready to be offered to potential investor to offer the area that are open to investment opportunity. West Java Creative Market located in Bandung that offered 4 hectares with their block area consists of stay, co-working space, and business center. Wana Wisata Theater located in Subang with the investment value 1.3 million rupiah with the 400 45.38 hectare that offered a sustainable concept of innovative, creative, and variative attraction such as adventure, conservation, tropical farm, public facility, convention area, cottage and restaurant, and also the beautiful improvement around the area. And for more information about another tourism investment product, you can scan. Yeah. And that is all from me about our province West Java. I cannot wait to you enjoy your time in here. Hope that we can meet when we are already. Thank you for your attention. Good afternoon.
Thank you very much, Mr. Dedi Taufik. We can see the potential of its tourism and creative industries. We should include this wonderful province on our bucket list. And don't forget the friendliness of its people, shown in their slogan, Smiling West Java. For our next presenter, Mr. Arifin Sujayana, we'll talk about the potential of West Java products, and he will dive down into the halal industry, something that is also important here in United Arab Emirates. Would you please give a round of applause for Mr. Arifin Sujayana?
Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon. My name is Muhammad Arifin Sujayana. Allow me on behalf of West Java government in the field of industry and commerce to give a short presentation about West Java export product and halal industry. Ladies and gentlemen, West Java province is led by a governor named Muhammad Ridwan Kamil and a vice governor named UU Rujhanul Ulum. West Java is the province with the largest population in Indonesia of the total population. West Java is a strategic province on the national economy with a prediction of 5.5% growth in 2021. The share value of West Java export for the period of January-August 2021 amounting to $21.56 billion or 15.18% of Indonesia total export, the provincial largest export value in Indonesia. Next. The value of non-oil and gas export in August 2021 has increased 15.7% from July 2021. It shows West Java export started to recover their condition gradually after the peak of pandemic COVID-19 in July 2021. And comparison of non-oil and gas export performance in August 2020 and 2021 has also increased by 37.54%. Next, furthermore, West Java export value to the United Arab Emirates countries in January-July 2021 increased by 40.1% compared to January-July 2020. Next, the largest exported commodities from West Java are dominated by machinery, electric, vehicle, and other mechanical products. In another side, there are 19 items such as fashion that are currently promoted to compete in the United Arab Emirates market within our visit in Dubai. Next slide. West Java is the largest industrial area in Indonesia. The product made are the best quality. One of the leading commodities from West Java are garment, textile, footwear, paper product, vehicle and machinery, and electric product. Additionally, West Java is also well known by its rubber, plastic, furniture, processed food, such as snack and cereal product. Ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia is a country with the most of population are Muslim. Based on this thing, Indonesia has great potential in the halal industry. Next. West Java has area named Segitiga Rebana or the Triangle of Tamborin, with advantages of transportation access through airport, harbor, toll road, and also railway. This area is intended for halal industry. West Java province has have some training institution that have been accredited as halal supervisor, including 1. IPB Halal Science Study Center, 2. Pasundan Halal Center, UNPAS, 3. Pajajaran Halal Center, UNPAD. Next. There is potential in the development of the halal industry based on the increase of industrial halal certificates in 2030 to 2019, West Java Industry and Commerce Agency has facilitated 6,845 small and medium enterprises to make halal certificates. This will continue with the increase of halal product demand, both in the local and international market. 10 priorities for halal industry. 1. Food industry. 2. Textile, leather, footwear, and other industry. 3. Transportation industry. 4. Informatic and electronical industry, ICT. 5. Energy generation industry. 6. Capital good component supporting material and service industry. 7. Agro upstream industry. 8. Mineral and base metal industry. 9. Health cosmetic and pharmaceutical industry. And 10. Chemical industry. Next, ladies and gentlemen, today we are here in the World Expo Dubai to bring outstanding product in the Indonesian Rolling Exhibition Room Pavilion. This product are representative of many quality product coming from cities in West Java, Indonesia, which we are specifically presented on this special occasion. The first is Ciwaringin Gown, woven gown from Tasikmalaya City. Jacket with combination of woven material from Majalengka City, as well as body mannequin that is specifically made from rattan. Next, various innovative products that are continuously developed to meet our needs, such as Sankimo Urine Bag, which is designed to meet people need in travel, military purpose, Hajj and children needs, where urine can turn into gel with special substances and can be used as fertilizer. Next, also leather product formed from bacteria called micelle. This leather is produced from coffee waste media which build an organic leather layer through biotechnology, producing alternative eco-friendly leather material using less water consumption, dyeing material, chemical, and shorter production time. Then Teh Dia, it's come from West Java based tea and stevia leaves as natural sweetener, which is more healthy. This mixed tea is the first in the world and be able to fulfill the need the top class of healthy customers. Additionally, we also have some selected press product that we can show directly, including Kini Paname Shrimp that come from Ciharas Village, Tasikmalaya City, that provide high quality shrimp that can be processed into various kind of food. Next, fresh pineapple from Subang, one of West Java famous pineapple producer. The product can be customized with the foreign buyer request. Ladies and gentlemen, I am afraid that's all I can say. Please try to use and enjoy the best product of West Java through World Expo Dubai 2020. And don't hesitate to explore other West Java product that are very interesting with superior quality. Thank you very much. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Mr. Arifin Sujayana. I hope this presentation will enlighten the audience in World Expo Dubai or those who join us via Zoom. As our last presenter, Ustadz Ferry from Darut Tauhid Islamic Boarding School will present several products from the West Java program, One Pesantren, One Product. One Pesantren, One Product is one of the special programs for Islamic boarding school across West Java to create an economic ecosystem. There are currently more than 4,000 Islamic boarding school joining the program, and several representatives from those boarding school are also joining us here via Zoom. Ustadz Ferry, the stage is yours.
Thank you very much. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ferry Risnandar. I am from Islamic Boarding School, Darut Tauhid, West Java in Indonesia. I will present about OPOP, One Pesantren or Islamic Boarding School, One Product. What is OPOP? Yeah, let's take a look at the following show in video, please. Next.
Pesantren adalah sebuah kawah candra di muka, tempat para santri menuntut ilmu agama dari masa ke masa. Seiring perkembangan zaman, kini pesantren harus memiliki kemandirian serta berkontribusi dalam membangun peradaban. Karena itulah, pemerintah Provinsi Jawa Barat membuat program OPOP, yaitu One Pesantren, One Product. Sebuah konsep pentahelix yang melibatkan peran pemerintah, masyarakat, akademisi, pengusaha, dan media. Program ini dirancang untuk membangun kemandirian pesantren agar dapat berdaya secara ekonomi. OPOP membantu pesantren dalam hal pelatihan, pendampingan, dan membantu memilih komoditi yang dapat diserap pasar.
Lahirlah sebuah gagasan yang kita mulai dengan konsep One Pesantren, One Product. Kenapa ke bahasa Inggris? Karena mimpi kita juara pesantren harus go global atau mendunia.
Mudah-mudahan dengan program OPOP ini, One Pesantren, One Product, seluruh pesantren yang ada di Jawa Barat tumbuh menjadi pesantren yang produktif dan yang mandiri.
Bayangkan, apabila seluruh pesantren dapat berdaya secara ekonomi, maka membangun sebuah masyarakat yang madani bukanlah sebuah mimpi. OPOP, One Pesantren, One Product.
Thank you. So, OPOP is the economic independent based on Islamic boarding school. Santri or student addition to studying religion or develop his economy. There are some of the sector development in the OPOP program. Sector fisheries, agriculture, trading, fashion and confection, food and beverage, service and other. Next. Okay. In 2019, we have a range of product from 1,074 Islamic boarding school. And 2020, there are 5,000 products. Then we offer some product that already have export quality is fisheries, Paname Sim. This is from Islamic boarding school Idrisia, Tasik Malaya, West Java. Next. And then this patient from Islamic boarding school Darut Tauhid. Yeah. This jacket suit is capacity 1,000 per month, business month. And next, fashion hijab from Islamic boarding school Pagelaran 3 is capacity 10,000 pieces in 1 month. And next, fashion from Islamic boarding school K. Haji Mulas Putri is a sarung, yeah, sarung in capacity 1 month, 10,000. Okay, next. This is a sector agriculture is a ginger, yeah, ginger and red ginger and thermetic. Yeah, it is from Islamic boarding school Al Ittifaq in Bandung. Okay, next. Then traditional supplement in black garlic, yeah, is from Islamic boarding school Nurul Iman in Bogor. Okay, next. Thank you. That's the product we offer the world. We all want. Thanks. Please order for your business need. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Ustadz Ferry. A very fascinating selection of products indeed. And now, that the presentation concluded, we would like to open the discussion forum. We will open 3 questions from the audience here and also the audience via Zoom. Bapak Ibu yang bergabung via Zoom, mohon menggunakan fitur raise hand jika ada yang ingin ditanyakan. Hari ini saya juga bertindak sebagai interpreter, jadi pertanyaan atau jawaban bisa diberikan dalam bahasa Indonesia. To the audience here, please raise your hand and identify yourself with your name and company name before you deliver your question, and also to whom you intended to ask. To our Zoom audience, you may deliver your question now. Ladies and gentlemen, you may address your question now. Okay. Please identify your name and your company beforehand.
Hello, my name is Samar. I am from Qatar. I work in a company of media. I wanted to know if your country in general has done any campaigns in the region. Because everybody knows the whole country, you know, and Bali is very famous, for example, but I didn't see much of the tourism campaigns. I'm interested to know more about that.
Thank you very much, Ms. Samar, for the question. So the question is, apakah West Java, khususnya Jawa Barat, sudah melakukan kampanye dalam dalam hubungan tourism atau pariwisata dan juga kebudayaan?
Ya, ini saya jawab aja ya.
Boleh, nanti saya translate.
Salah satunya adalah di tempat ini ya, kita mempromosikan tadi adalah pariwisata Jawa Barat yang memang begitu besar, yang memang bisa dikolaborasikan terutama tadi dari Qatar ya, yang bisa menikmati alam Jawa Barat ya, seperti Bali lah. Keindahannya hampir sama dengan Bali. Tadi saya mau putar video tadinya. Itu aja mungkin.
Terima kasih Bapak. So the answer is, this event this week is part of the campaign to introduce to all the people who's visiting Indonesia Pavilion, especially about the tourism and the culture that we have. So tomorrow will be the last day of today's event, which is the West Java Week. So make sure you will hang around. And also, especially we have the entertainment at the end of the day about the dances and also the presentation about the potential tourism and culture that West Java has. Do you have any other question that you intended to the speaker for today? Thank you very much for your question. Is there any question here from the audience offline and for audience in online as well? Do we have any question from our audience in Indonesia? Yes, please.
Regarding the halal product, since I live in Qatar, you know, I find it very interesting. Do you sell any of your products made in Indonesia in Qatar already?
Pertanyaannya adalah, apakah ada produk halal Indonesia yang sudah masuk ke Qatar?
Oke, datanya nanti kita coba cari. Hanya memang kita mencoba untuk mempromosikan produk halal kita ke negara-negara Muslim, khususnya di Uni Emirat Arab.
Jadi sudah ada produknya sudah ya, ada. Pak ya? Ya. Kalau boleh tahu contohnya seperti apa tuh, Pak?
Makanan.
Okay. Halal food
dan fashion.
Yeah. Okay. Terima kasih, Pak. So we've already has a product that sells in Qatar such as food, halal food, and also fashion. Since Qatar is part of the Gulf country, that is a Muslim country as well, so we have the similarity about the hijab fashion, and it's really popular there also. He can also provide you with the data if you would like to know later on, so you can just come and then ask about the data, and then we will have a private discussion or a personal discussion later on after this session. Thank you very much. Now I would like to open another question since we have a three question. It's been two already. So is there anyone who would like to ask again? Okay, so we have one question from our online audience. May I please have the question? Pertanyaan selanjutnya akan datang dari audiens kita yang bergabung via Zoom meeting. Sebentar lagi saya akan mempersembahkan pertanyaan dari audiens kita yang ada di Indonesia. Okay, so there's no question and answer session. It's officially ended by now. And as we're approaching the end of today's event, we would like to thank everyone for joining us today, especially to our honorable speaker and all distinguished guests. On behalf of West Java team, we thank you and we'll see you in another time and have a great day. So before we're leaving the business lounge of Indonesia Pavilion, we would like to deliver our special merchandise to our special guests today. So please hang around a little bit because we would like to present you with a little bit of something of West Java. To our guests, please do not leave the business lounge yet. Thank you very much for coming to our today's session in West Java Week. We hope you enjoy your time with us today and we look forward to seeing you again soon.
I'm sorry, can I ask something? I have one question.
We may take a picture together. Please join us on the stage today. Thank you very much to all our guests once again. We hope you enjoy your visit today in Indonesia Pavilion, especially in Java West Java Week. I hope you enjoy your time here and we look forward to seeing you again soon.
Khalaqallahu azza wa jalla arda pasundan farihan mutabassiman. Lahal funun wal thaqafat wal mawarid at-tabi'iyyah al-wafira. Wahia taj'alu jawa al-gharbiyah tu'arafu bil jannah al-badi'ah al-makhfiyah. Ibda'ul khaliq bimtiazat wa ni'am. فتكون هذه العتية مصلحة للناس جميعا. حضر العيش فينا من محاصيل هذه الأرض وراثة من السلف الأولين، فجعلت الابتداع والابتكار فليس لها إلا مجرد الاستخدام، بل لها أيضا قيمة تجارية. ها هي مسؤوليتنا كشف التراث الثقافي حافظا وتطويرا عليها، وتنمية التقاليد الإقليمية بالذوق الدولي استعدادا لأجل الحرفيين المبتكرين، وترويج المنتجات لتوسيع الحصة السوقية في الداخل وخارج البلاد. المجلس الوطني للحرفيين اليدوية محافظة جاوة الغربية هي المؤسسة المستقلة غير هادفة للربح، كان شريكا لحكومة محافظة جاوة الغربية في تنمية القدرة التنافسية للحرفيين الإقليمية. فنحن نفتح الفرصة الواسعة على الحرفيين والراغبين للابتكار والاشتراك في تنمية القيمة لتقوية الهوية الثقافية للأمة.